Yogita Mani, past circular HLC 45. I am a baker and I started my own venture, Baker Wish, a year ago. I'm very passionate about the baking. I started baking when I was just 15 years old, and all during my journey I thought very small mistakes make our baking goods into disasters. So I feel that I thought I should share some of my baking tips with you, so that on your special occasion or anniversary or birthdays, you can bake your own cake and make your family and friends happy. These are some of the instruments that you require for baking, which are really helpful and help you to weigh your ingredients properly. Weighing or measuring your ingredients is very important step in baking. These are the measuring cups and the spoons, easily available at the local market, or you can order online. This is a weighing scale, which really comes handy if you want to weigh your ingredients exactly. This is a blender. This is an electric blender, and if you don't have electric blender or you are not a regular baker, you can use this hand mix for mixing the ingredients. This is a mixing bowl. These comes in 2 to 3 sizes and very useful while mixing all your ingredients. These are silicone spatulas. These are must, because your batter doesn't stick and you can easily remove the batter and put it in the baking tin. These are some of the baking tins. So whenever you find any recipe on the net, and when they give you a cup of measurement, usually this is the mistake what all people do. This is not a cup. You have to follow a spoon and level method. This is exactly a cup of maida or any other flour. Even if they tell you a teaspoon of, these are the spoons. This is 1 tablespoon, 1 teaspoon, half teaspoon, and 1/4 teaspoon. So we should not measure the baking soda or baking powder with normal spoons. Using these spoons is must for baking. Sieving is also a very important step in baking. It helps to make your cakes rise and make them soft and fluffy, and also to remove any impurities. If your recipe says to add baking soda and baking powder, add it in the flour itself. And if you are using unsalted butter, you should always add at least 1/4 spoon of salt while sieving. It gives your cakes a very good taste. Now about using baking soda and baking powder. Always use good quality baking soda and baking powder, and use it before 3 months of manufacturing. A lot of people get confused using baking powder and baking soda. Baking powder already contains an acidic ingredient, but baking soda doesn't. So whenever your recipe has any acidic ingredient like curds or vinegar, then only baking soda is used.
It is always necessary to prep your pan before you start the recipe. You can either grease your pan and dust it with the flour, or use parchment paper. There is a difference between parchment paper and a butter paper. I usually order this Odi EcoBake parchment paper online. This is the best brand I have. I feel, and it's heat resistant. Butter paper usually sticks to the bottom and it absorbs some of the oil or butter from the recipe. So you always use parchment paper. Fold the parchment paper in a square. Take your pan. There are other methods, but this is the simplest method that I used. Now about using your oven. Many people use OTG for baking, but I have this inbuilt oven. This is of CAF company, and there are different functions.
upper rod and lower rod and fan, and only lower rod and fan. But for when it says preheating, you have always have to use this function: upper rod, lower rod and fan, and 180 degree preheat. Keep your oven for heating for 10 to 15 minutes before putting your cake in it. And when it's after putting the cake, you have to come to the only fan and the lower rod option. So it gives even baking for the cake. In the excitement of baking, one of the major mistakes people do is to open the door frequently to check if the cake is done. What happens, the temperature varies and the cake sinks in the middle. So please don't open the door minimum for 20 minutes. Usually cake always bakes from the sides to the middle. So to check if the cake is baked, you use one toothpick and insert it in the middle of the cake. If the toothpick comes out clean, your cake is done. And if the batter is stick to the toothpick, you need to bake it for some more time. By using these simple tricks, now you can bake a perfect cake. Thank you.